You will get the most from any Systems to Win video when you launch it from its video homepage.
This is the fourth video in the 7 video series to learn how to use your standard work template. The first 3 videos were pretty much all about observing the process and documenting the way the process is currently being done right now. In the next 4 videos, we're going to teach you how to use your powerful new tool to analyze and improve that very same process so that it produces with higher quality, lower cost, and faster delivery. And the purpose of this video is to focus on operator workload balancing and value add analysis. Let's start with operator load balancing. We've already done the hard part of programming the chart, so now you can use everything that you know about Excel to perhaps move that chart to wherever it's most convenient for you at the moment or within the print area. Or you can copy the chart or resize it. It's Excel. Use everything you know about Excel. Now the program is set up to allow as many as 20 operators. Now this chart shows 10 right now. What if you only wanted to show those 3? Or what if you wanted to show all 20? How do you do it? You scroll over to the right until you find this section that has the formulas for operator load balance. And then you can either unhide as many as all 20 operators or hide to show only the number of operators you want, in this case 4. And then when we scroll back to the chart, your chart shows 4 operators. Now notice that this operator load balancing chart includes a factor for personal fatigue and delay, which is something you'll learn about in the next training video. And it also includes a prorated time per unit for things that happen at a frequency cycle other than the run cycle. So things that happen every batch or shift cycle or twice a month. So that makes this operator load balancing chart useful in ways that are different from a Yamazumi chart. Now, Yamazumi in Japanese means stacked, so you've got a stacked bar chart, and in this case, what's being stacked are the work elements performed by each operator. There's a column for each operator. And that makes a Yamazumi chart very intuitive and easy to understand. Now it's relatively easy for anyone to make a bar chart in Excel. What makes your Systems to Win template so much more powerful is that we've done a lot of fancy programming to make it easy to rearrange and do what-if analysis very rapidly. For instance, let's say that for a different level of customer demand, maybe Christmas, we need a 4th team working on this process. And then maybe we determine that this work element could be moved to have operator or team 4 do it instead of operator 1. And maybe this work element might also be moved to operator 4. So now you're seeing why in the first 3 videos we emphasize the definition of a work element. Because each work element really does need to be able to be moved and handed off to another worker. And when we click the Update Chart button in our Systems to Win menu, the chart does what a homegrown chart can't. It instantly reflects all of your changes. But you say, wait a second, that tack time's way too high. The whole reason that we had to have 4 operators is that we didn't have as much time available. So let's change that target cycle time, which is usually identical to tack time, down to maybe 5 seconds. And click the Update Chart button again, and now we see that we have a problem. That 4th operator's cycle time is going to be greater than the tack time. So the team talks about it and decides, hey, what if we did a Kaizen event to reduce this wasteful step here so it only took 1 second? And we click the button to update the chart again. So your Yamazumi chart is a very powerful tool to quickly rearrange things and brainstorm alternative ideas for how you might improve a process. And then once you make your decisions, you can later use other tools to more thoroughly document and control that process. So where did those times come from? You could have used any one of your time observation worksheets, but most commonly those times will come from one of these three columns from the time observation section of your standard worksheet, either the repeatable second fastest or the median average or the mean average time from your time observations. So if you're going to copy your data from your standard worksheet to a Yamazumi, there's two things you need to know. First is that you'll copy over only those work elements that have a frequency of the run cycle. In other words, it has a frequency code of either run or blank, which is the same as run. So let's scroll down to operator 2, where we will select only these three work elements. Why? Because operator 2 does this first thing on a batch cycle and this last thing three times per shift. So these are the only three things that this operator does every run cycle. And we copy it, Control C. And here's the second thing you need to know. When you paste, you don't just use regular paste. You right click, paste special values. And that way you're pasting only the values of those cells, not the formulas and not the formats. And then the same thing, when we copy the values from one of these totals columns, we don't want to copy over those nasty formulas that won't make any sense in another workbook. So again, we right click, paste special, values. And then when we click the update chart button, we now have our work elements and times in our Yamazumi chart. So why are those stacked elements gray? Because we haven't yet used this drop-down list to select our value-add codes. And how do we know what those value-add symbols mean? If you've ever used any Systems to Win template, you already know the answer to that. You can click any row or column header for pop-up help. Or you know that every drop-down list is always defined on the DV worksheet. And you can see the descriptions that go with any codes there. And when you click the button to update the chart, your chart colors match your value-add choices. It just doesn't get a whole lot easier than that, does it? So on the standard work combination sheet, when we look at the pop-up help for the value-add codes, the pop-up help tells us that we have the same three classic codes that we saw on the Yamazumi chart, but there are also two additional codes, one for walk and one for weight, and those will become really important when we click the button to chart all operators, but they're pretty self-explanatory. And there's also blank, and let's talk about that. So if we delete this code for this work element, watch how our pie chart instantly changes. And now there's a bigger slice of the pie for this other category. And although the pie chart will have only one slice for that other category, you can optionally use this category field to choose from your own drop-down list of your own user-defined codes for types of waste, which are, of course, defined on the DV sheet. And if we scroll over, we find where we can define our user-defined category codes. Most commonly, you're going to filter for changeovers, and we'll come back to that. But the other thing you can do is filter for types of waste, either the classic seven deadly types of waste and or your own user-defined categories of waste, which can be anything that you observe in your process that you want to get rid of. So back on our help sheet, the pop-up help restates what we just said. that you can use this category field for any user-defined purpose, most commonly changeovers and user-defined types of ways, but it could be anything, using Excel's powerful filtering capabilities. And if we select this link to go to the online training, there's online training and even a video to teach you how to use Excel's filter if you don't know already. But let's do it together. First thing we'll do is select this drop-down list for the name box. And then you select the very first item in that list, which is called A Filter Data. And remember, that's Systems to Win's special way of ensuring that you select the correct range of cells. If we just allowed users to select their own range of cells, they might select something like this, and then filter wouldn't work. So once you have selected the correct range using A Filter Data, you're now ready to select the Data tab and then click the Filter button. And then select the drop-down arrow for the category column, uncheck the checkbox for select all, check the checkbox for what you want to filter for, in this case changeovers, and it filters for only those work elements related to changeovers. And now in the subtotal cells at the top of the columns, we can see the total time per batch devoted to changeovers, and we see the total time per unit devoted to changeovers. Alright, let's end this video by reminding you of something that's extremely important in the Excel training section on your help worksheet. It reminds you, especially on a template like this one, don't use insert rows. Instead, you want to insert copied cells, and it also has a link to online training for how to move entire rows. Let's do it together though, because this is so important. There are two ways to move rows. The first way is to select the entire row and then cut, Control X, and then select the cell in column A for the row we want to paste to. Right click that cell, and then select Insert Cut Cells. And then let's change the operator number in that moved row, and notice how our chart changes. And we say, oops, that isn't going to work. Operator 2 is over tack time. So to move it back, we could just use Control Z to undo, but let's show you the second way of moving. We select the entire row, not just partial cells, the entire row, very importantly. And then we hover our mouse over the edge of our blue selected area until our cursor turns into a four-sided cross arrows. Then we right-click to select the selected area. And still holding that right mouse down, we drag. And when we release our right mouse button, we select Shift down and move. And then change the operator number back to 1. And that's the second way of moving rows. And if you need to add a row, do not use right-click Insert Row, because your inserted rows will be missing all of the formulas. So the correct way to add a row is to select a similar blank row, copy it, then right-click the cell in column A for the row where you want to paste, and select Insert Copied Cells. And then notice that your newly copied row has the formulas that you're going to need. Now that's so important that you should probably use your newfound skill right now and burn it into your memory. Do it on your sample sheet, so that once you learn how to move and copy entire rows, you're going to use that Excel skill a lot.